record.
Hi, folks. This is Kevin Knebel in beautiful Monument, Colorado, and I'm delivering a brief webinar today on behalf of the Schweike Media Business Booster Webinar Series on LinkedIn Groups. And I'm going to talk a little bit about how to leverage LinkedIn Groups for lead generation, marketing, business development, branding, and all kinds of sales and client acquisition purposes. So real fast, just a quick bit on me. I'm an international speaker, author, trainer, advisor. I'm a published author with McGraw-Hill on this subject of social media. I previously was the top producing salesperson in the world for an international consulting company in 11 countries. And nowadays I speak all around the United States and internationally on a weekly basis and train organizations on how to blend old school sales networking and relationship skills with new school social media. So, enough about me. Right now you're looking at my LinkedIn homepage. And LinkedIn has recently reconfigured a lot of the search functions, so I'm going to show you how to get to LinkedIn's groups, which is now different than it used to be. It used to have a very simple button right up here that said groups, but now we can go to the advanced search function. And then when we get into the advanced search function here, we can go into advanced one more time, click on more, click on groups, and let's say for the sake of argument, we want to find people in a chief financial officer position. Let's just go with that. So I want you to keep in mind, think about traditional networking. Think about if you could do business with people in a certain position, field, industry, whatever. Remember that LinkedIn is a database. So let's say for the sake of today's purposes, I'm going to type in CFO. But as I do this, I want you to keep in mind the kind of people that you would want to do more business with. So I'm going to type in CFO, hit search, and LinkedIn is going to search through a couple million groups on LinkedIn. Come on, LinkedIn. There we go. And it looks like there are 1,419 related groups related to the term CFO. Now, for those of you listening to me in San Diego or those of you listening to me in Boston, I could type in Boston CFO or San Diego CFO. So obviously, 1,419 results is huge. You're never going to be able to deal with all of that. So you might want to refine this down to your local geographic market or the place that you want to do business so you understand that LinkedIn is a database. So just for these purposes, let's click on this group right here, Chief Financial Officer Network. If I were looking to do business with chief financial officers, I think that going to a group called CFO Network would probably be a good idea. So right now we're looking at the group homepage. And as we scroll down this a little bit, over here where it says check out some insightful statistics and view group statistics, let's click on this because this is a good thing to do to determine is this a group that I would want to network in. So in here I can see that there are 147,371 members. Holy cow, that's a huge group. I can see that there were 134 comments last week on discussion threads, and I'll show you the discussion threads in a moment. I can see that 6% are in the greater New York area, 43% of the people in this group are in a finance function, which makes sense, it's a CFO network. I can see that there's 32,051 people at a CXO, 26,000 at a director level. So this page right here is giving me some background info. Let's look at some demographics. This will actually show me in a little bit more detail functions, locations, industry. So you can really get a feel for this group before we even determine, or as a way to determine, is this worth our time and effort to network with these people? Is this group growing or dying? Well, this group is definitely growing. 867 new members last week. My goodness. 4% week over week growth ratio. And for the people that are analytical, anal retentive types with tape on their glasses and pocket protectors, you can have a field day with all this kind of data down here. And then you can also look, like we said, 20 jobs were posted last week, 6 promotions, 302 discussion threads. So if you're looking for a group of CFOs and the kind of people that are in that general category, this looks like a really good place. So let's look at some of the discussion threads. When we click on discussions, this is showing us any of the discussions that are going on in this LinkedIn group. So I can see here that 2 hours ago, this person, if I put my cursor over, or if I clicked on this, I could see the name of the person that posted this, but 7 ways to ignite innovation. So somebody posted a discussion thread here 2 hours ago. I could see this gentleman here posted a discussion thread 16 days ago, and he has 59 follow-up comments in chronological order. And all the people that have posted follow-up comments, I can see exactly who they are, where they live. I can see who I know that's connected to them, because remember that LinkedIn's a database, and it works in 3 degrees of separation. So all I'm showing you here is a way to just kind of mine through this group to identify discussion threads and places where maybe I could engage in conversations with people. Now, keep in mind, so I'm actually not a big proponent of the word social media. I'm a much bigger advocate of the word social networking. And the reason for that, and I'm going to oversimplify this, is because media tends to sometimes be a one-way monologue. No offense to Schweike Media, because I know that's part of their name, but in my simple mind, and remember, I closed a lot of bars in the 80s and I killed a lot of brain cells, so I got to keep things simple. In the 80s, you know, media is a one-way monologue. TV is media, radio is media, billboards are media. And really, in this more and more interconnected world with things like the internet and social media, it's not so much about monologues anymore, it's about dialogues. It's about engaging with people and engaging in dialogues. And that's why I'm a big proponent of the word social networking. The challenge for most people is they've never really studied networking, whether online or offline. I've been speaking on stages for almost 20 years about how to create endless pipelines of referrals and leads through time-tested, proven networking, relationship, and sales skills. So everything I teach is about how to blend old school with new school, because I'm an 8-track player in a world of iPods. So that was my long-winded way of saying, just like in the real world, you shouldn't run into a networking meeting throwing business cards at people and doing what I call kissing on the first date. You should be approaching people with the attitude of, let me learn more about what you do, so that as I come across people that I think might be a good fit for what you do, I can connect you with those people. So don't run into a LinkedIn group and start posting things like, here's my product, or doing what I call kissing on the first date. Always lead with value. So you could make sure when you do engage in these discussion threads that you're not being salesy or slick, you're offering value. And then certainly connect with the people that you're engaging with. But here's a real simple tip that I could give you that have helped, this one tip has helped my clients so much over the years. If you would just once a week or so go into the LinkedIn groups that you're a member of and just post a discussion thread, and it could just be a link to an article that you found on the internet somewhere, an article of value. So if this is a group of CFOs, I know things that are important to CFOs, and even if you didn't know what was important to CFOs, you could learn it very quickly looking at this discussion, these discussion threads. So if I know that they're interested in, let's say, medical benefits or Obamacare, or they're interested in their P&L statements, or they're interested in taxation issues, I could very easily go to Google, type those words into Google and find a million articles on that, and I could go over to my LinkedIn group. I could write as a discussion thread, here's an interesting article on taxation or whatever. I'd love to get your thoughts. And then I copy and paste the link to the article, and I just post it as a discussion thread. And all I'm doing is I'm throwing out to the group an item that might be of interest to them to see if anybody bites. And if they bite and they engage in that discussion thread and they post a comment, well, now you're playing ping pong. Now you're playing tennis. They've hit the ball back. And now you can engage in a conversation with them. But again, remember, don't come on strong. Don't start kissing on the first date. Don't just engage them in a conversation. And at some point in that conversation, it's going to make sense for you to get connected on LinkedIn, maybe go to a phone conversation. And if you're in the same geographic area, maybe have a cup of coffee. So really, what most people need to understand as it relates to social media is that most people need to get better at networking, not just being on the internet staring at a computer screen, because it really comes down to the networking skills. So maybe once a week or so, post some articles in some different discussion threads and see if you can start some conversations and see where it goes from there. You can join up to 50, that's 50, you can join up to 50 groups. So I would strongly encourage you to join anywhere from 15 to 20 groups as quickly as you can. You should belong to some peered groups, but really you should be joining groups of the people that you want to do business with, not necessarily your peers. So if you're in sales, again, back to my original example here, if I sell to or network with or refer to or from chief financial officers, it makes sense for me to join some CFO-type groups. So in here you can see latest updates, discussion threads, you can see all kinds of information in here, and this is just a good habit to get into. It's also a good habit to get into when you see people that you respect or consider to be centers of influence or a leader in an industry, look at what groups they belong to on LinkedIn, because maybe you'll find some nuggets there that you had never even thought of. So have some fun. You have promotions where you can blatantly pitch and sell a product in a promotion area. You don't want to do that in a discussion thread. You can see that there's jobs where people are actually posting leads to jobs. So I know many people that have gotten jobs through looking through the job function of LinkedIn groups. And there's also the new search function where you can break down, you can look for certain keywords within polls, certain discussion threads, discussions you're following. LinkedIn will update you and keep you notified of any additional follow-up comments on discussion threads that you're engaged in. So we're going to wind this down real quick. Just as a recap, there are, I think, currently about 2 million groups on LinkedIn. You can join up to 50 groups on LinkedIn. So if you find one and you're already at 50 and you want to join it, you have to unjoin one of the groups and join the new group. But most people don't even come near 50 groups. But you should join at least, I would say, a dozen to 20 groups as quickly as you can. If you will use your LinkedIn groups and LinkedIn the way I teach it, which is get on LinkedIn every morning for 15 minutes before you open up that email inbox that hasn't gone down to zero since 1995, you'll have a lot of success in using LinkedIn groups. See, the problem is most people treat social media the way they treat a gym on January 1st. They say, it took me 30 years to get this out of shape. I'm going to get back in shape in 30 minutes. No, you're not. You're going to pull a muscle and have an aneurysm. The smartest thing you can remember is that small efforts over time produce massive results. When you spend 15 minutes a day on LinkedIn in the morning before opening up your inbox and your email account, over the course of the next 30, 60, 90 days, you're going to start to see some great things happen with your LinkedIn efforts. My name is Kevin Knebel. This is my website, kevinknebel.com. It's 5 letters. Could I please buy another vowel? Vowel, K-N-E-B-L is my last name. That's me there, face for radio. Please feel free to go to my website, sign up for my blog, sign up for my newsletter. I do speaking, I do training, I do a lot of work in multiple industries. I do a heavy amount of work in the financial services industry. But please feel free, if I can ever help you in any way, I'm extending my hand in friendship, and I give you my word that if I can help you, I will absolutely help you. And I want to say thanks to the fantastic people at Schweike Media. I love doing these brief and to the point and succinct webinars on behalf of the Schweike Media Business Booster webinar series. Make sure you do more business with Schweike Media. These are good people, and they run a fantastic business. So on behalf of the Schweike Media Business Booster webinar series, this is Kevin Knebel in beautiful Monument, Colorado at 7,500 feet of altitude, signing off and wishing you a great day. Have a great day.